Okay, I would like to about the theorem of the Kamar-Chaussade, there is a very short proof that I did not mention yesterday, which is a proof due to José Camon. And which uses Puiseux expansions. If you know, there is an algorithm which is due to Puiseux to find the solution of solutions of solutions y of x of p of xy, where p is a polynomial. And you find this solution by Puiseux expansion, and you can adapt the proof to the case of vector field in C2. But I wanted to explain you Kamar-Chaussade formula for another reason that I will explain. But first of all, I would like to mention that if you are interested more on the subject, there is one book that I know in English, which is a book that has been written by Ilyashenko and Yakovenko. This book, you can find the reference in my notes. But you can find also, after you will have read my notes in French, so you will be able to read more French. And then there is a recent book of Felipe Cano, Dominique Servaux, and Julie Desarty. Okay. There is a book also of Laura with Javier Gomez Mont in Spanish. I think there are some courses in Portuguese that you can find on the website of the UMPA. So, in English, I think this is the only one. Okay. So I would like to go back to my initial problem. Find rational solutions of the differential equation dy over dx equal r of xy, where this is rational. So why I can write it like this, P of x over Q of x. And as I explained the first course, you can do it by this way. You fix a bound for the degree of P and Q. You have a finite number of coefficients. You put it in the differential equation, and you get linear equations on the coefficients, so it is a linear problem. You can find all solutions of a given degree. So the problem was to bound the degree and the solution is Kamar-Chaussade formula. So you start with your differential equation, which gives you a foliation by curves that you can look in C2, but after you can compactify in P1 plus P1. So this gives you a holomorphic foliation by curves defined by the differential equation. And this compact manifold. So you have some singularities, and now you assume you have rational solution consists. So the rational solution may pass through singular points. So I denote it by C. And so C is now, C is a double invariant curve for the foliation F. And the degree of C, that is the max of the degree of P and Q, is relating to the self-intersection of C. In fact, if you think of C as in H2 of Z, so in H2 of Z, you can think of C as a section, horizontal section, S, plus the degree, so the degree I will denote it by D, plus D times the fiber. So if you have such a curve, this in homology, where this is a fiber, any fiber, and this is a horizontal section, so a fiber for the other position, then you see that C times C is equal to so S times S plus 2 times D times S times F plus D squared times F times F. So these are fibers, so they do the self-intersection is zero. Horizontal section self-intersection is zero. And this section on the fiber self-intersection is one. So you find 2D. So the degree of the curve is half the self-intersection. So now the idea is to apply Kamachosat formula. Kamachosat formula, so you look at your foliation. There are finitely many singular points, and at each singular point, you have finitely many curves. No. You look at the possible invariant curves. And for the possible invariant curves, you look at the possible Kamachosat index. So say lambda 1, lambda 2, lambda 3, and so on. So for you look at this for each singular point. So in case you have infinitely many invariant curves, actually they share the same Kamachosat index. So what you can check from this picture is that you have finitely many possible Kamachosat indices for local invariant curves. So now you look at all possible sums. Integral that gives you integer. So for instance, the curve, if you look at the invariant curve, So here, it can pass out of the singular set. It can pass through lambda 3, singular invariant curve, lambda 2, lambda 1. And you have to check all the possibilities. So over each singular fiber, if you I can say like this, you look at all the possible Kamachosat index. And you look at all possible sums, so there are finitely many. And this gives you a finite possibilities. For degree of the invariant curve. So when you have a bound, so you can check with a linear equation and make the list of all solutions. Okay, now we could be interested to find algebraic solution. Algebraic solution, that means you look at y of x implicitly. Defined by some polynomial of xy equal to 0. So how to find such solution? So the idea would be the same. The idea could be, okay, you look at the degree, so you have a bigger degree for such a solution, so P of x has a degree in x and a degree in y, so you have a P degree. So each time we fix the degree in y, we have the same answer. So you will have a more complicated curve. So for instance, if you look at a polynomial of order 2 in y, so you may have something like this that after intersect here and so on, some ramified cover of the base like this. But you can do just the same, count all possible Kamachosat invariants. And you can also relate the self-intersection with the b-degree. Here you have a b-degree. So here the b-degree will be, let's say, n. So 2n. And you can do the same. You can relate the n with the self-intersection and find all solutions that are defined by such a polynomial equation with given a bound on the degree of y. So the problem is if you want to relax any condition on P, then you cannot control the number of sheets. And if you have what we call decritical points like this with infinitely many separatrices, then the invariant curve can pass an arbitrary
n number of times through this, and you can you cannot bound. You know here. I know if you have, I have finitely many separatrices, I know that the curve can pass only once to each other. So if I have not this kind of singularity, I can find a bound for all algebraic solutions. But as soon as I have such singularities, this is what we call the Poincaré problem. And it is still open. So one of the main steps in this problem was a theorem which is due to Manolo Sternicer about so who proves that if so I did not define, so I don't know if it makes sense, but anyway, if f is degree d, I write, sorry. Non-decritical means that you have finitely many separatrices. When you look at the resolution of the singularity, it means that all components of the exceptional divisor are invariant for the foliation. Yesterday we have a discussion, Laura and myself, about some polynomial which can be identically vanishing or not. So it is a case where it never, it is not identically vanishing. Non-decritical. Then, there is a conclusion. Any invariant model has degree at most d plus 2. So it is in P2, we were in P1, first part P1, but it is the same because you can compactify as you want. And then the degree of the foliation is not exactly, but something like the degree of the polynomial defining the foliation, or the polynomial coefficient of the vector field, more or less. And so you have a bound like this. Okay, so I would like to show you a special family of foliation where you see that the problem is very difficult actually. So there is a family of foliation which has been studied by Alcides Sins Neto. About 10 years ago. So his paper is called On the Poincaré Problem, so easy to find. But I would like to present another example. So it is by a Riccati foundation, Riccati equation. So now for a special family. So consider 4 points on the Riemann sphere. Let us call them 0, 1, infinity, and t. And the family of Riccati equations with simple poles at 0, 1, infinity, and t. And local involutive monochrome. So I explain. So it will be of this form, dy over dx equal k0 y squared plus b0 y plus c0 over dx plus a1 y squared plus b1 y plus c1 over x minus 1 plus at y squared plus bt y plus ct over x minus t, and all ai's, bi's, ci are the constants. So this is the definition of this Riccati equation with three simple poles at 0, 1, and t. And in this form, it could be checked that it has also only a simple pole at infinity. So now, what is local involutive? I would like, so remember that such equation has some monochromy. Representation. You have here C, well, the, now the Riemann sphere, and there you have 4 points, 0, 1, infinity, and t. And now you choose a base point, and you look at loops. It is better than that. Turning around. So generators for the fundamental loop. And you can leave the loop in the foliation upstairs. So the foliation is over this. So you have 4 vertical leaves, and the other leaves are transversal to the vertical vibration. So you have the lifting path property. You can lift the loops, not as loops, but as paths in the leaves of the foliation. And so by this way, taking the transversal which is here, you can have defined return maps around all of the singular points. And so you get
from the P1 of C bar minus 0, 1, infinity, and T to PGN2. So this was explained by Adolfo. And now the generators are phi 0, phi 1, phi infinity, phi t. And you can, and you have that the product of these matrices is the identity, obviously. And the condition involutive says that I require that all phi I are involutions. So how to impose this on the differential equation? In fact, you have the following. If you have if you look at the discriminant P0 squared minus 4A0C0, you can write this as minus theta squared, and then, so this is the definition of theta, and then there is this PGN2 change of y coordinate around x equals 0, sending the equation 1 to dy over dx equal to theta y over x, except when theta is an integer. And the monodromy is easy to compute here. The monodromy is y to e to pi by theta times y. So we have a control of the local monodromy from these numbers. So choose all theta i's equal to 1/2. And you have automatically this condition. So this gives you a family of Riccati equation like this. So you can write a list of equations. So by P, PGL2 change global, so PGL2C. So here it was PGL2 of O of C0. You make a function, a change of a Möbius change of the y coordinate, but the coefficient depends on x. But you can do a global change of coordinate. This is P0, P1,
pt, and actually there is the singularity at infinity, where you have this relation, p0 plus p1 plus pt, plus p infinity equals 0. So this gives you a way to compute the polynomial at infinity. And you can change the coordinates so that the residual polynomial at infinity is equal to, say, minus 1 half, minus 1 half of y. So now the list of equations for my family is as follows. So I have already imposed at infinity the right condition. And now I have to impose the condition on the 3. So this condition is equivalent to say that the sum, so a0 plus a1 plus at equals 0, b0 plus b1 plus bt equals 1 half, c0 plus c1 plus ct equals 0. These are effective mathematics. And you ask that bi squared minus 4 ai ci equal to minus 1 over 4 for I equal to 0, 1, and t. So you have a system of equation. And when you have done this, you'll find three degrees of freedom. But actually, you have still some PGL2 action, which comes from the fact that there is not a unique way to normalize P infinity like this. So there is one degree of freedom to do this, and if you keep this degree of freedom, at the end you have the manifold of such equation, which is a surface. Space of such equation up to PGL 2C is given by the following one. You can reduce to three essential variables, which are, let me check, so you can do the exercise. Not now, it takes some time. X equal P1, Y equal P2, Z equal A1, C2. So these are the essential variables. From them, you can reconstruct uniquely this equation with all the conditions up to PGL2 action. But they are linked with the relation. The relation is the following one, Z square. Plus 2z x minus, minus 1 for 1 minus 1 for plus x squared minus 1 over 16 y squared minus 1 over 16 equals 0. So this is an affine surface. So this is the invariant theory that Mike was explained by Javier yesterday. And so you have some surface with three singular points. And so now I will explain where they come from. So I would like now to talk about the monodromy and why I choose this family. So you can consider now the elliptic curve y squared equal to x, x minus 1, x minus
So if you don't know what is an elliptic, forget it. It is a curve of genus 1, which is defined as follows. So you have the x-axis, which is belonging to P1. And now you have the roots of the polynomials. And actually, you have to consider also the infinity. And this curve is can be drawn like this. Okay, I draw it like this, and you can imagine that it is actually the part of a torus, the real part of a torus. So the curve is equivalent to C quotiented by lattice, so it is a torus, a two torus. So you have this curve, and you have the projection onto P1, which is given by the variable x. So it is a two-fold ramified cover of P1. And now if you look at the monotony, you can lift it on the two torus. So you have, I can consider the, okay, the following. So I have the representation from the which is here, okay. And now I can look at the fundamental group of two torus minus the same four points. You know the point I see is M on the torus. So this is X star. Okay, so I have now a representation of the two torus minus four points into PGL2. But if you look at what happens locally around the puncture, then the map from y, by y is a regular local coordinate on the curve here, and the map from y to the to x is 2 to 1, is ramifying at the other two. So if you lift up the local monodromy becomes the square upstairs is a square of the local monodromy downstairs. So it is the identity. So actually you can erase this point and you have a representation of the two torus in PGL2. Okay, so this implies, so I prove that this relation implies that there is the two-index subgroup, which is generated by phi 0, phi 1, and phi 1, phi t, is abelian. Because this is the two. Okay. So there are several possibilities. So in fact, this implies that the monochromy of the Riccati equation is either contained in the infinite dihedral group, which is the group of transformation of the form of AY or A over Y, where A is existant. So the group which is preserving the pair 0 infinity,
or it is contained in the affine. I don't know how to, if there is a notation, a standard notation, which is a fine version of this, which is plus or minus y plus t, t belonging to c, the fine version of this group. So the singular points stand for the fine monotony, and for the other one you have this kind of monotony. But you have an inclusion. This means that it is a subgroup of this, and this subgroup can be finite or infinite. I give you the explicit coefficient and I ask you how to decide. And I don't know. And I can explain it a little bit more. So I lift up the monodromy, but you can lift up the foliation. So I have the recursive foliation. So you have four vertical lines, and there is an invariant curve which comes from the fact that d infinity preserves zero infinity. So you start from a transversal to the foliation, and then you look at the monodromy group, and in the monodromy group, you can conjugate it under PGL2 to this. And then you have two special points with respect to the monodromy. So you look at these two points, and you can look at the leaves, the corresponding leaves. And the monodromy of this leaf is of order 2. They can be only permuted. So this gives you, I will make the this gives you a curve which is a two-fold covering, so an algebraic curve which is of degree 2 over x. Actually, it is you have c which is a p degree. Two curve. So you can compute this curve because you know the mid-degree, and after computation you find it explicitly from the coefficient. It is unique, and it is the unique mid-degree 2 curve which is tangent to the four vertical lines and tangent exactly at the point where you have d-critical points of the foliation with infinitely many local invariant curves. Okay. And the other leaves, if you are here, they have infinite monotony. So they intersect the transversal in finitely many times, or finitely many times, and you are in the end. So now what I want to do is to lift up the foliation on the elliptic curve. So I have now the elliptic curve, C over gamma, times P1. And I lift up the foliation. And now, when I do this, I keep the ramification. So the picture should be something like this. you have two sections now. So one I did not see zero, one I did not see infinity. Okay? And so I can do some virational transformation to separate these two curves. So for those who know, it is what we call elementary transformation that can apply at the four points where graph intersections. So it consists in blowing up the point. When you blow up the point, you have an exceptional divisor. You have a strict transform of the fiber. And you have the two curves, C0, C infinity. This has minus one set intersection. This has also minus one set intersection. You can contract the fiber to a point, and then you get a new P1 bundle with where you have separated the section. So this is contracting to the point. And you do it for all the fibers. And then what you get is the following. You have now two sections, C0, C infinity, and now a regular foliation on it. Very nice. So this is a flat line holomorphic. Okay. So a flat holomorphic line bundle is well known for those who know flat holomorphic line bundle on elliptic curves. That it has finite holomorphy. If and if it is finite with respect to the tensor product as a flat line bundle, flat line bundle, it is a line bundle together with a holomorphic connection, and you can do tensor product for this. And it implies in particular that L has an element of the bigger group that has been defined yesterday. Bigger group of the elliptic curve is finite. But in this case, the Picard group is isomorphic to C over gamma, to the elliptic curve. C over gamma, which is also a group, because C is an additive group, and the group structure is preserved by the quotient. So you get a group structure on the two torus. And you just ask that this line bundle is the torsion point of the two torus. So this is a condition to have finite monotony. And how you can find this point? So I go back here. I look at the horizontal passing through one of the singular points here. So it is a pedigree 2-2 curve, so I will have another intersection point. For this, I can compute this point from the equation of the differential equation explicitly. So it is given by the coefficient, the function of the coefficient. So now I blow up, and it is intersecting, it is a section which is intersecting C0 and C infinity. So here you have a point that I call E0, and here you have some point which is you are on the elliptic curve, so it is x0, y0, and x0 minus y0, so I'm conjugate. And unfortunately, we have not seen the definition of Picard rule by divisors, but this defines you a divisor on the curve, and we have to look at this divisor and check that it is finite. Finite or not. But at the end, the conclusion is the following. We get an explicit point x0, y0 on the elliptic curve y square equal to x minus 1, x minus t, and we have to decide if it is the torsion or not. So maybe in the case of elliptic curves, this is okay. We can do it because there is a bound which is due to Mebel in 1996. In case the coefficients are algebraic, if it is an algebraic extension of Q, you have a bound for the possible order of torsion point defined over a given finite extension of Q. But you can repeat this construction with more points, 6 points, and then you lift it up. You will leave the foundation on the hyperelliptic curve of genus 2, and you have a divisor that you can compute explicitly, and you have to ask if you are able to decide if it is torsion or not. I think it is open. It is an open problem. So I don't know if we can decide. So to end, I would like to mention a recent result. So this was a problem of algebraic solution. And you can look at explicit solutions. You can imagine with some exponentials, some logarithm, you make a combination of this, and can you find an explicit differential equation like this? So there is a theory which is in between holomorphic foundation and algebra, which is a differential Galois theory, and one of the beautiful results is as follows. If, so it is a theorem of not recent, of Michael Singer. If, so say dy, no, dy over dx equal p of xy over q of xy has Liouville solution. Liouville defined a class of function which is somehow what we can expect as an explicit function. So this means explicit. Then the differential equation has admit an integrating factor. So I will say like this that the foliation. The foliation is transversely affine. So I do not detail, but there is another theorem. You will not understand the assumption of the theorem. So if is a transversally affine foliation, on a projective surface, for instance P2, then you have one of the two possibilities. The first one is that there exists some finite cover such that the lift of F on this finite cover has is defined by a closed rational one form. In foliation theory, this is very nice. We have almost a first integral closed rational one form. The holonomy is abelian, everything is very gentle. Or there exists a map, this time from x to p1 plus p1. Plus R, which is a Riccati foliation, such that the pullback of the Riccati foliation is your foliation. So either you are in a very nice situation, or by pullback, or actually you are coming from the Riccati foliation, and not any Riccati foliation, and a fine Riccati foliation. That means that here you have only a fine and a fine polynomial in one that you can solve. It is like Bernoulli or equation you can solve. You have it in the classical books. So the classical books contain all explicit solutions in some sense. So the theorem. So it has a long story. So if at the beginning it was the thesis, there was the thesis of Scarpa, and then there was almost at the same time the paper of Sekosa and several papers of Camacho Scarpa. And the final step was given 2 years ago by Cousin and Pereira. So 2012, where you have no assumption. And stop here. Thank you.
Thank you very much.